25 years ago, you guys, our next guest moved from Queens to a deluxe apartment in the sky.
I love this show. Did you love this show?
Absolutely. It was cutting edge.
I know, absolutely.
And these days, they are delighting a whole new generation of fans. Take a look at this clip.
A couple of years ago that we'd be living up here in style, looking down on the greatest city in the world.
No, I didn't. And I must admit, it's wonderful.
You know something, Weezy? We were meant for each other.
Oh, thank you, George.
New York and me.
Where did you
Thank
learn?
Thank you, my people.
The clip we played. Did you see the clip we played at the beginning?
Yeah.
You
dance? Can we show that again?
Oh, that is so funny.
Where did
Go
you
Sherman.
Learn?
Go Sherman.
Oh, yeah.
Go Sherman. Go Sherman. Go
Sherman. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Can you still do that?
Oh, yeah.
You can do that?
Sure.
Oh, let me see. Play
Go, Sherman. You know, you think back. 25 years ago, you were strutting it, and you're still strutting. Did you ever think that the show would be as big as it got?
It's and huge. It's still 25 huge. Years later.
Not at first, but why do you have to keep numbers? Get numbers. It makes it sound so cool. I met a man the other day, 65 years old. Say he grew up watching our show. I'll say now, this is getting ridiculous. Everybody I meet said, you know, I grew up
but
watching.
But that's such a compliment, isn't it? A group?
Yeah,
like,
it
maybe
is.
Not. Maybe not.
Sure. Sure.
I'm sorry, but I love your sense of humor. You're writing, aren't you writing an autobiography?
Yes.
Yeah.
I feel the world should know what I've been doing and what I am doing
what I
will do.
Is it strange to do that? Is it cathartic? Is it something that you're enjoying?
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
I love this. Well, I knew I was going to do this since I was 9.
Really?
I didn't know I was going to be this magnitude.
No, you know what? That's really true because I saw the old Navy commercial that you guys did. I mean, you guys are just pop icons again. Was it fun?
Yeah.
More people know of us of the old Navy than they do of the Jeffersons.
That's right.
Everywhere we go, I saw the old Navy. By the way, they got somebody else doing Old Navy now. I'm wondering if they'll call us again.
They should call you again.
Yeah. They will. Yeah.
I think that we should. Everybody, email them.
You know,
right in.
Before we go any further, I want you all to know this is pretty significant. But because both Isabel and Sherman were on the original Donnie and Marie show, and I'm going to embarrass you, Isabel.
No.
I'm going to embarrass you. We got a picture of you as Mother Goose. Would you show everybody Isabel as Mother Goose?
Oh.
I want to see you after the show, Donnie.
Well, Sherman's over there laughing. You're not getting off so easily.
Wait till you see what we have coming up after this.
Uh-oh.
We're going to go to commercial break, and when we come back from commercial, I got a picture of you. You're going to die. More with the Jeffersons when we come back right after this.
Isabel Sanford and Sherman Hemsley.
Moving on up.
Yeah.
To the east.
I want to see you dance going out of this segment again.
All right, no.
Now they are moving to a deluxe apartment. Well, I'll tell you, it has its pluses and its minuses. For instance, George, he was always stuck with a pushy maid, an in-law that he could live without, and a tip-hungry doorman. Take a look
always
at this.
Always wanted
money. Hey, everybody! Hey, y'all! Come on out here, quick!
What's the matter?
I just saved his life.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Now, let me tell you how I did it.
Later, George. I'm just dying to show Helen my new dress.
Let me tell you how I did it.
Not now, Mr. Jefferson. I gotta fix dinner.
It can wait.
No, it can't. I'm hungry.
Please welcome Marla Gibbs, Franklin Cover, and Ned Wertheimer.
Just sit down.
Frank is doing it again. He does this all the time. He embarrasses me.
Does he really?
How does it feel
to be
together?
That's the first time any white man has embarrassed a black woman.
But you know, that's an interesting thing you bring up because your show is such a cutting edge. I mean, you pushed the limits. Interracial marriage.
Did you have the first one?
Yes.
I think you did. So.
Yes, and the last one. Well, it seems to be that.
That's right. Yeah.
No, he was the black woman's burden.
That was Roxy's line.
Yeah, Roxy.
Oh, yes.
But she didn't read her contract. Her contract stated that she had to drive me from my apartment out here to the studio. And she said, why am I doing this? Why don't you rent a car? I said, I don't have any money. I have no money. So she said, I have to drive you? And I said, yeah, you and Paul Benedict. And they drove me for about 2 years.
You are kidding.
No.
And then I took the bus in the morning. They didn't have to pick me up in the morning. And then I would get a ride at night. And then we moved to Universal, and I said, I do not transfer. So I got a car. I finally got a car.
That's good. That's good.
I rented a car.
You know, it's funny because I remember watching the show, and Ned, it was so funny because being the doorman, you always had to... You had your hand out all the time. You always wanted money.
Always. I even talked this way.
He still has it out.
And you know, just so you know, I have to pay you for... You wanted some money to be on the show, so here's a dollar. And now you can stay on the show, okay? Okay.
You know, I have to tell you...
The first time in
television.
Marla, I'm keeping that.
I know you're keeping it.
Marla, I love your character. Thank Absolutely you. Hysterical. Did you base her on anybody, or did you...
My grandmother and my aunt.
Really?
Really? Mm.
That must have been a fun household.
It was, but I couldn't laugh. Everybody could laugh but me.
Yeah. Do you guys get recognized on the street?
Constantly.
I got recognized in Port Harcourt, Nigeria.
What?
My wife, I'm married to a PhD in Cal State University in history. And she's from Nigeria. She went through Howard University, got her PhD. We were visiting family 2 years ago, and we're ready to fly away home after Christmas. In Port Harcourt, Nigeria, waiting at 12 o'clock midnight in Air France to board the plane, and a guy sitting across from us said, I had my beard then, he says, don't I recognize Ralph from the Jeffersons?
Amazing. That's the power of television.
It is.
It is.
He was a professor here, and he was home visiting, and he used to watch the show. But of all places,
on a different subject here, how did you all get along with Roxy?
Roxy, fabulous.
Yeah. We lost her.
About four years ago?
Yeah. Roxy was about the sanest one of all.
Really?
She was wonderful.
Well, I wouldn't say.
Well, outside of Miss Sanford.
Well, Roxy, you know, Lenny Kravitz is her son. Yeah. And
that's right.
Yeah, he just did a big concert downtown. But he's such a sweet guy.
Are you all fans of Lenny Kravitz?
Yes.
I don't like the music. I've got to be honest. I don't like that music. I love Lenny, but I'm glad he's a big hit, but I can't stand the music.
Well, don't expect to be a guest on our show when Lenny comes on the show, okay?
He knows that.
Okay.
You told him that?
But he told, yeah.
You're going to have Lenny on your show?
I'm going to try. I want
to
get him on.
He said, do you remember when I used to come over and play soldiers with your son and everything? And they were really, you know, into it. And in New York, you know. When they still lived in New York, and we did too. And so that relationship was just wonderful. I was so glad to work with her.
Yeah, we lost her about 4 years ago, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
And she was a wonderful woman.
Out of all of you, who was the jokester? Franklin was the jokester.
Nah. Him and Paul mostly. Paul Benedict, I think.
Yeah. Well, what were some of the things
Paul,
they did?
He's Paul's, like a kid.
I have something to say about Paul Benedict. That he's in Music Man right now on Broadway. He's playing mayor of the town. Now, he played Mr. Bentley on our show.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's right.
And so he's got a big hit. That's great. He got a terrific review. He's doing great.
Really?
Yeah.
The show, by the way, next fall, just I want to mention to everybody, is going to be on the Screen Gems Network. I mean, it's just a show that just keeps going and going and going. When you think back all those years, do you have like a favorite episode that sticks out in your mind?
We all do.
We all have. You have your favorite?
Well, mine was the Small Businessmen's Association.
You know, why was that?
I won the award for
the small businessmen.
I thought it was for having the small business, but it was for small guys, 5'6" and under.
Yeah.
And we found everybody 5'6" and under.
And the whole cast, I'm looking around, so there's a lot of tall women here, you know?
Yeah. Isabel, do you have a favorite one?
Well, the one with me and Sammy Davis Jr. Okay, that was my favorite.
Yeah.
Well, what about you, Marlon? Do you have a favorite?
Yeah, I have more than one. I have one with me and Billy Dee.
Love that. Yeah.
And then one where Ralph and I played the Willises.
That was great.
Oh, that was great. Yeah.
You'll be able to catch them all now this fall, as I mentioned, on the Screen Gems Network. Guys, it's great to have you here.
So fun.
You should do a reunion thing
real
soon.
You really should.
A reunion thing.
We've been trying to do one for years.
Yeah? You should do it.
If we could only get our same writers.
Yeah. Well, the time is right. It feels right.
The writers is what.
Yeah. You never had a season finale. You should do one.
Yeah. Don't bring that up.
You should.
Well, right now you can catch the Jeffersons weeknights on Nick at Night. And remember, this fall on the Screen Gems Network. Thank you, guys.
Let's dance.
We'll be right back. Go for it, Sherman.